Welcome students, in this video we will learn about the kings of Bukkaraya and Proudadevaraya. Shall we start? We will learn about the next ruler of Sangama dynasty, that is Bukkaraya. He ruled from 1357 to 1377, that is almost 20 years. Bukkaraya was brother of Harihara. He took over the power after his death because Harihara had no son. So naturally he was the next ruler. During his rule, his son Kampana expanded the empire by defeating the Sultan of Madurai. This was explained in a book of Madura Vijayam, which was written by Kampana's queen Ganga Devi. She was a great writer, author and poetess too. During the Vijayanagara Empire, women were given a lot of importance and freedom, because if you have a very famous female writer at that time, it means that time women were given lot of freedom and importance too. Bukka captured Penukonda, which is in Andhra Pradesh. Bukka captured Penukonda by defeating Reddys of Kundavidu and included it into Vijayanagara Empire. Shravanabelagola inscription means Shasana, that means some things inscribed in or written on the stone. Shravanabelagola inscription of 1368 CE explains Bukkaraya's rules. What it tells? Pacified the conflict between Jains and Vaishnavas and maintained the religious harmony and equality. He ensured that religions did not fight each other. That means people of all religions lived in peace. He ensured that all religions are equal. Kings ruled Vijayanagara after Bukkaraya. Harihara second, Bukkaraya second, Virupaksha second and Devaraya first and Veera Vijayaraya. There was ruled from Vijayanagara Empire. But these were not so famous. But Devaraya second, who is also called as Proudadevaraya, he is one of the most important figure in this dynasty. Next, we learn about the famous king of Sangama dynasty, that is Proudadevaraya. He called as known as Devaraya II. Devaraya II, who is also called as Proudadevaraya, he is one of the most important figure in this dynasty. He ruled from 1424 to 1446 CE. See this picture, that is Devaraya II. Devaraya II, one of the most famous kings of Sangama dynasty. His period was very significant, means very important in the Vijayanagara dynasty. So now we will know about why is that his rule was very important. See what he did after he took over the power, that means after he became the king, he built a new army. So he brought him some changes. So he brought a new army which included the Muslim soldiers. That point of the time, it was very revolutionary thing that he did it. He included Muslim soldiers in the army. Why he included? Because they were skilled in archery and horse stamming. Okay, archery andreno bilvidye, billu bana bidodu. Horse stamming means, you know, they could control horses, they could take care of the horses, so the horses could use effectively during the wars. So with the help of this army, he defeated Reddy leaders of Kundavidu region. What is it he did to? He defeated means he saved it from the attack. He defended famous Mughal fort Raichur and Bankapur by fighting with Ahmad Shah of Bahmani Sultans. So when there was an attack by the Ahmad Shah, what he did? He saved and ensured that they were not successful in these attacks, and he saved Mudugal fort and Bankapur. His brave commander called Lakkanna Dandesha, who is very famous. He defeated the kings of Kerala and Sri Lanka and collected treasure and tribute in cash from them. That means they become subservient from them. That means they become subservient to the Vijayanagara rulers. Proudadevaraya had religious tolerance, means not trying to prove one's on religions superior, treating all the other religions equally and with respect. So that is the meaning of religious tolerance. What proves that he was religion tolerant? He built a Jain and Vaishnava's temple in the capital and even permitted to build mosques. So these two facts proves that he was religiously tolerant. Some of the people patronized by the Proudadevaraya are Telugu poet Srinatha, Sanskrit philosopher Dindima, and Kannada poet and the minister Lakkanna Dandesha. Was patronized means he encouraged and supported. Patronized means ashraya nidudu, supported them. So these are people that was supported or encouraged by him. You must have heard Varisu Kannada Dindimava, right? Next, Veerashaivism got resurrected in his period. Resurrected means punarjivana, punaruttana, that means rebirth. See, how do we know that Vijayanagara Empire, especially under Devaraya II, was very prosperous? Persian ambassador Abdul Razak visited Vijayanagara Kingdom during Proudadevaraya period and stated, what he stated? I have seen such a rich kingdom like Vijayanagara Kingdom for the first time. The capital had 7 forts and the Raja's army has lakhs of soldiers. So this is not some imaginary story. This was written by a foreigner. He was a Persian ambassador. He had came from Persia from political matter. He was surprised to see how the prosperous the state was, and it is own words that he told. Proudadevaraya was popular and he did lot of great work. He also had many of the titles. What are the titles? Yes, he had a lot of titles. That is Gajabentegara, Chatushtamudradishvara, Airarya Vibhada. So these are some of the titles he had by Proudadevaraya. Then what happened? Unfortunately, he died in 1446 CE. After his death, his son Mallikarjuna ruled from 1446 to 1464. And then Virupaksha III was ruled from 1465 to 1485. But they were weak ruler, and because of this, a strong commander Saluva Narasimha captured the capital and he took advantage of the situation. He saw that the ruler, they are not strong, so he took over the command. With this incident, the rule of Sangama dynasty ended in 1485 CE and it gave a birth to a new dynasty called the Saluva dynasty. So we will study more about Saluva dynasty in next video. Thank you. This is your today's homework.